comes the new intake. Or I should say, old but new to me. No, it was always mine. Goofball. I almost forgot all about this. But here's the anti-resonator, which actually is what makes this intake, the stock one, so much quieter instead of the rumble with the short ram. Oh no! Everyone wants to have heard the short ram. How does this even go in here? Short ram did add a little bit of rumble. I'll admit that. If I remember right, I actually had to disconnect these to get them under last time. Probably gonna have to do that again. Because it just doesn't want to get under. And this needs to be on there because otherwise you're sucking unfiltered air. This little vacuum control device can help me squeeze under without disconnecting. Now, I don't like connectors. They're difficult. But at least Nissan spent a little more money on the plastic, so they don't break. Be careful. Maybe even use a clean rag to keep you in your engine bay. I'm installing the connector behind it. You know what? Maybe that would work too. Because that, whatever gets me more play, right? Plus then I can't plug this into the wrong one. Well, last time, that's not how I did it, but maybe it'll work this way this time. I actually left this in for a while with this short ram, just because it's such a pain to get out. But it was vibrating against the short ram's air, metal air tube, and it didn't sound good. Say, oh, well, it helps if you get to the actual quick release. There we go. That's gonna come apart. Get the wire out of me. Okay. So that's on top. The other one's on the bottom. I can tell because this one has a white label on it that this one doesn't. Like I said, maybe make this easier next time. Get a little bit of dirt off. Don't bother to put silicone on them. It won't help. Because that will just evaporate. What's funny is they're so concerned about this truck being quiet that they actually have this anti-resonator box go onto some rotted rubber, and I might have to, yeah, the 10 millimeter, I'm gonna have to pull this ground as well just to put this under. Maybe that's not a 10, or maybe the wire, I pulled it up. There we go, that's sitting in. Careful of that. There we go. Now she'll go in. The stock intake's so quiet, I'm not really worried about the fact that these rubbers, they sit on her rotting a bit. Okay, I think I'm gonna have to unbolt that just to get it in. Which, on an installation, I just use more force. Sometimes works smarter, not harder, right? Oh, and this intake is sold by a lot of sellers, but I will put a comment up about who I bought it from specifically. Not that they're, like, gonna make me any money on these. Probably very little profit wiggle room on them. But they just were nice, you know? I couldn't figure out how to get the silicone boots on because I didn't realize one was 2.75 inches while the rest were 3. He was real patient. He answered my questions promptly. And helped me install. I just posted some pictures up to him on in an eBay message. And then don't forget the one with the white label goes in on the bottom. The other one goes on top. And the third one's a unique connector so you can't mess it up. And there's actually a backing that these go on to. Kind of have to hit both of them at the same time because they're very tightly connected in through the wiring harness. Alright, now keep your tube up where you find it. Don't forget, otherwise one of your vacuum control devices will not be working. And I gotta go grab the stuff. See, the kit came with tons more tubing than you need for the short distance between here and here. They give you tons of it. They also give you a short one to replace this in case it does eventually crack, because they don't want, I guess, you know, it's part of the look. It's blue, it looks cool. All right, so in comes the intake tube. And now what was fun is I'm lucky I didn't set a check engine light or anything, but had a little fun. Where are my tubes? Clamps on the underside. What am I trying to do to myself here? Don't forget these. They're actually necessary to go in between to get these hooked together. First, I gotta get these clamps back on the top side. I don't know how I got that flipped over, but I did. The first time I ran this system, I actually ran it with this tube because the other tube was at home. It's 90 degree pliers make it possible for you to see more of what's going on in the shop. Make it easier for me to stay out of the shot a little bit. There we go. Okay. And it should be difficult to install if you don't make it easy on yourself. And I've accidentally had these in too far before. It still works. I've had this centerpiece disappear just because I pushed them together too much, but that's okay. It's not a big deal, it works either way. Now, I could use the technique I learned from Brian's 01 and push these apart and make sure they're on really tight, but I'm not worried about that until everything's fitted, because I still have to make sure this one, I'm just not feeling it. It's going in deeper. That looked like that tip was too short. This tip looked better. I'm confident that it's not going to have a vacuum leak. Maybe move that back there for a second. Oh, that makes it worse. Back as far as it can get out of the way. Yeah, I had a feeling that was in there backwards. Maybe take the time to use silicone before you put them on instead of after. Get them off. Hey. Yeah, I feel like that end goes this way. I know I'm not listening to my advice. Make it easier. And silicone is rubber safe, so you won't have any issues. Originally was, seals really well. You get a little off, it could be an air leak. Put these on, flip them over. Is it my problem that I have this installed upside down? Yeah, that's why these are flipped over, guys. I put it on upside down. Okay, I'm not going to record flipping over, but laugh with me, all right? Switch over to 9, listen to the language kids shouting and yelling. Oh, and I forgot. Big on guy on here is actually an 8. Big guy on here is an 8. So you have to do a little switching of your tools. I tighten it up so I don't lose it over the season. This should all go on pretty easy, so don't worry about the silicone. Okay, that actually took a lot of force. So if you're not a strong mechanic, use the silicone. Now I'm making excuses just to be funny, huh? Okay. That's pretty well set up. Just thought I'd clean that out where you could hear the neighbor's kids real well. Kind of annoying, huh?
Typically speaking, I go outside to work on my cars to not hear my kids, but this one time out of all the years I go outside to work on stuff, I heard the neighbor's kids instead and about drove me nuts. See what I mean? I'm sitting inside and some kid wants to go off. I do love being a dad though.
Figured that was all future dirt that I didn't need my air filter, my Canon air filter to clean. Canon air filters are controversial. I don't think they give you any power. I had a real dirty Canon air filter, didn't lose any power, none, had full power. Put in a clean air filter, it wasn't a Canon, a paper one, had the same amount of power. Now, dirty paper air filter, I think restricts power, because sometimes people are like, wow, my car feels a lot better when they change the air filter. But, sorry if you can't hear me, kids are loud, and I got a deep voice, and squeaky voices carry better. But I just figured I'd keep my air filter cleaner by having the pipes be clean again. It's okay if it's a little wet. It's not like it. I mean, I believe in water decarbonization. Check out my popular video here. I'm not worried about that. I just wiping out more of the dirt.
Actually, that was a really dirty air box. 102,222 miles I just saw the other day. So, yeah, that's never been cleaned. Now, first you got your bottom piece that goes in, and I'll have to take the reference bolt out. And once again, do not forget, this is your moment. It's your moment to be awesome. Do not forget this. I'm a little ahead of that because it actually goes on the top of the box, but still. Orient it right. So it goes in for our fake air filter or fake cold air stock air intake.
Get out to there and work on something. I'll answer your car questions as soon as I'm done watering the grass.